can you quickly find the isoelectric point for this peptide without a calculator? Or how about this one? The isoelectric point, or PI, is the pH at which a molecule, in this case our peptide, has a net charge of zero. But first, let's review isoelectric points for amino acids. As I teach in the video linked below, this drawing of alanine is incorrect. Because the amine group has a pKa of 9.69, MCAT students memorize about 10, and the carboxy has a pKa of 2.34, MCAT students memorize about 2, the structure will change if I change the pH. At a very low pH, say 1, every group is protonated for a net charge of plus 1. At a very high pH, say 11, every group is deprotonated for a net charge of minus 1. How did we know? As I teach in my zwitterion video, the pH and pKa are fighting for a proton. pH refers to the solution, or team solution. pKa refers to the side chain on the molecule for team molecule, where the higher value wins the proton. What happens if we pick something in between, say 7? At a pH of 7, because the pH is greater than the pKa, team solution wins a proton and pulls it off the molecule. Deprotonating the carboxy gives me an O- for a charge of negative 1. At pH 7, the pKa is greater than the pH, so the pKa wins a proton for team molecule, protonating the amine and giving me a charge of plus 1. Plus 1 and minus 1 gives me a net charge of 0 despite having two charges on the molecule. This is the zwitterion. We randomly chose 7, but pH 6 and 8 are also above the carboxy pKa to give me the negative, and also both below the amine pKa to give me a positive. So which is it? To find the PI, take the average of the two pKa values. Using our estimates, we have 2 plus 10 over 2, giving me 12 over 2, or 6. Biochem students, that's 2.34 plus 9.69 over 2 for 6.15. For the remainder of this video, we'll use the MCAT memorization values. You can find the full table on my website linked below. What if we have a third pKa value with another ionizable group, or more? There's a long way that you learned in lecture, where you first draw the entire polypeptide, noting all the pKa values, then guess a random pH to find the net charge. But first, we see what we're working with. Draw your polypeptide. No, not like that, the faster way. Since all we really care about are the ionizable groups, let's not waste time with anything else. MCAT students, yes, you have to memorize them. The left of the chain has an amino terminus. The right has a carboxy. For the side chains, only draw the atom or group that's relevant to ionization. That's an SH for cysteine. Lysine is a mess. I just care about one hydrogen and nitrogen. And tryptophan doesn't have an ionizable group. The amine group has a pKa of about 10. The carboxy is about 2. Cysteine is about 8. Lysine about 11. And tryptophan has nothing. Are you ready? Step 1. Arrange your pKa values in order from low to high. That's 2, 8, 10, 11. 2, 8, 10, 11. Step 2, protonate every ionizable group. The amine gets an H for a plus 1. SH is protonated, has a charge of 0. Lysine, don't worry about how many hydrogens, and imagine the rest are there. Just know that a fully protonated nitrogen has a positive charge, regardless of the hydrogens. The carboxy is already protonated for a charge of 0. Step 3, find your max charge. That's the highest possible charge when everything is protonated, as we have here. That's plus 1, 0, plus 1, 0, plus 1, 0, plus 1, 0, for a net charge of plus 2. Step 4, count your way up to 0, and this is the tricky part. Remember that if pKa is greater than pH, the pKa wins a proton for team molecule, and everything is protonated. If I pick a really low pH, for example 1, every single pKa value is greater than 1, and everything is protonated, as we see here, for a charge of plus 2. If the pH is greater than the pKa, Team pH wins a proton for team solution and pulls it off the molecule. If I raise the pH above the first pKa, the carboxy gets deprotonated. This gives me a carboxylate with a charge of -1 for a net charge of +1. If we start with a charge of +2 and raise the pH to deprotonate the carboxy, my charge goes down to +1. If I raise the pH again above the pKa for cysteine, I deprotonate sulfur and get a charge of -1 for a net charge of 0. Without looking at the molecule, can you see how if I jump to the next value, I'll get -1 and then -2? Give this video a thumbs up if you're with me, and let's move on to step 5, solve for pI with a pKa above and below 0. Our max charge when everything is protonated was +2. Our minimum charge when everything was deprotonated was -2. But that doesn't matter. What we care about is the charge of 0 and the pKa values around it. Identify where you got 0 and use the pKa directly below and directly above. Our pI value will be somewhere between pKa of 8 and 10. Plugging it in, we get pI is equal to 8 plus 10 over 2 for 18 over 2, or 9. Biochem students, that's 8.33 plus 10.78 for a final pI of 9.56, which on the MCAT is close enough. Want to try this one? You're more likely to see it written out like this, and we only need the components. Start by filling in only the ionizable components of your side chain. Arginine is too complicated. We just need a nitrogen. Methionine gets nothing. Tyrosine as an alcohol. Leucine gets nothing. And aspartic acid just needs an OH. Let's add a protonated hydrogen to arginine. Next, add your estimated pKa values. That's 9 for the parent amine on a basic amino acid. The rest are 10. 2 for the parent carboxy. 12 for arginine. 10 for tyrosine. And 4 for an R group carboxy. And now we follow the steps. Step 1, order the pKa values. That's 2, 4, 9, 10, 12. That's 2, 4, 9, 10, 12. Step 2, protonate everything. We'll have the amino group as an NH3. Arginine, who cares how many, we'll just know it's positive. Each oxygen already has a hydrogen. Step 3, find the max charge. A maximum protonated nitrogen is +1. That's +1 for the backbone, +1 for the side chain. A protonated oxygen is neutral, giving me 0, 0, and 0. Add them up, we have positive 1, positive 1, 0, 0, 0, positive 1, positive 1, 0, 0, 0, for a net charge of +2. Step 4, to find 0, we put the maximum charge below the lowest pKa value, and then decrease by 1 as we move past each subsequent pKa. Step 5, to solve for pI, find 0 and take the pKa value above and below, in this case 4 and 9. pI is equal to 4 plus 9 over 2 or 13 over 2 for 6.5. Biochem students, that's 3.86 plus 9.04 to give you 6.45, which on the MCAT is close enough. But what if you're asked to draw this peptide with R and S amino acids and then convert them to D and L Fischer projections? That's exactly what I cover in this video, which you can find along with my amino acid practice quiz on cheat sheet on my website at leahforsci.com/aminoacids. Again, that's leahforsci.com/aminoacids.